Crew AI.
Having your own crew is awesome. But if the crew is actually doing the work, then it's an agency, right? So in this video, I'm going to show you how to convert your crews into agencies and actually make them do the work. Let's dive in. For this video, I created a notebook for you, which you can find in the description, and a custom GPT inside that will help us to significantly streamline this process. In this example, we're going to be converting their famous trip planner. Okay, the first step in our conversion process is to convert the tools. As I always say, tools are the most important, so you always have to start from the tools. And all you have to do to convert those tools is simply open this custom GPT link and then copy the code and drop it here. Yes, it's as simple as that. This custom GPT has access to both Crew AI and Agency Swarm documentation, along with some additional instructions for conversion. So as you can see here, it first provides the Crew AI code and then it simply converts it into the base tool class in Agency Swarm framework. Let's copy this code and now I'm gonna explain what exactly it did. So basically in Crew AI, the tools are defined with special decorator functions from LangChain. And this has a couple of problems. First of all, you can provide the types for the arguments and descriptions. So if we look at how schemas are defined on OpenAI or on any other large language model providers, here we have properties. And properties not only have types, but also descriptions. But when you define a function like this, the problem is that you obviously can't provide any of those properties. You can provide the description and you can provide the type. So what typically happens in production is that your agent starts to confuse the type of the argument. And it personally happened to me multiple times when I was testing this notebook. Basically, the agent was trying to provide the list instead of a string for the website. And then it was running into issues with API requests and then trying to correct itself. While in Agency Swarm, you provide the type using standard Pydenic model. So here, as you can see, the custom GPT automatically extracted the type for the website parameter and also provided the description. And all of those descriptions and types will automatically be passed into the OpenAI schema definition using Instructor library. Yeah, Instructor is a genius project that allows you to structure LLM outputs using Pydenic models. So now let's convert the next couple tools and then I'm gonna tell you how to convert the agents themselves. Okay, cool. So hopefully all of those work. Make sure to double check the code because obviously custom GPTs can sometimes be wrong. But yeah, I think this looks good to me. So let's proceed to actually converting the agents. For this demo, we're also gonna be using the new GPT-4 mini model, which I'm really excited about because of how cheap it is. Yeah, so here it did convert all of those agents properly. Basically, all we have to do is to put the goal into the instructions and the backstory you can either put into instructions or in the description. Basically, all they're doing is just passing those goals, backstories, and roles into prompt templates and then sending them into instructions on OpenAI. So the reason they do this is because of the way their framework is structured and because if you just don't provide those prompts, most likely the agent communication is not gonna work properly. In Agency Swarm, however, all communication is handled by a single tool, which means that you don't have to provide any prompts at all. Okay, so now let's proceed to the tasks. So as you can see, we're replacing all of those tasks with simple get completion calls. And the reason for that is because tasks are also prompt templates. Yeah, so here basically we have this prompt method that creates a prompt from the task by combining all of those expected outputs, descriptions together. Yeah, so that's basically it. All of that is just useless abstractions that take away control from you as the user. And it's not just me who's saying that, you know, there are other companies that are no longer using LangChain for building AI agents, again, because of the same problem. So as you can see on this blog post, here's a comparison of a call to OpenAI that takes 14 lines of code. And here's the same exact call to LangChain, which takes 18 lines of code. So the question is, what's the reason for adding all of those abstractions if they in fact only increase the number of lines of code that you need to write? And additionally, on top of all of that, of course, they take away the control from you as the end user. Because imagine if you want to modify any of those internal prompts, leave alone if you want to modify how the system actually works, you basically have very little flexibility in order to do that. And Crew AI, on top of all of these abstractions in LangChain, adds even more abstractions. So now let me show you how this is done in Agency Swarm. In Agency Swarm, all you have to do is just pass it as a message and that's it. So you just write your task description exactly as you would write it in Crew AI, except there are no prompts. You know, if you want to have expected outputs, all you do is just add another line at the end, and then you just pass this message into the agency.getCompletion method. So yeah, this looks good to me. Let's proceed to now actually converting the crew. I know it's a lot of Ctrl C, Ctrl V, but don't worry, we're gonna be replaced by AI soon anyways. Yeah, so basically all you need to do is just add your agents into agency chart. And inside the agency chart, you can define any process that you'd like to have. So it doesn't need to be hierarchical, sequential, or whatever. You can create any process you want because the communication flows in my framework are uniform. So this means that you can add as many agents as you want. You can structure your agencies in any way you want. So here, basically, the city selector agent will be able to communicate to local expert agent because they're in a second level list, and the top three agents will be able to communicate with the user. So you can create as many of those lists as you want and place as many agents inside as you want. And anytime you place an agent like this, it will be able to communicate and assign tasks to the agent on the right. Yeah, so for Crew AI, it definitely takes much longer because they're doing some planning under the hood. And again, planning is easily solvable. You can simply add into instructions, you know, please plan your actions step by step. Or a cool trick that I like to do when using my framework is you can add a special chain of thought parameter. And then in the description, you can say, please think step by step about what you're gonna do next and what websites you want to search. Now the model will be forced to actually plan its actions before executing this tool. The benefit of using that compared to a global prompt is that the model will only plan its actions when using this tool rather than on every single step, which might not be necessary. Also, it's a bit strange that they use like another special prompt inside, you know, do I need to use a tool on almost every single message? Because with function calling models, there is really no reason to do that. You know, the function calling models can determine for themselves whether they need to use a tool or not and then simply call it if so. And then as you can see, the agent gets the error when if this was done in agency swarm, basically, first of all, the agent would be able to see in advance that the input must be a string, not a list. And secondly, it wouldn't call the API before getting the error if for some reason it still provided incorrect input. And in production, as you might know, some really bad things can happen if you call APIs with wrong inputs. Okay, finally, it took it like 10 minutes to come up with this response. I'll run it again and time it for you, but to me, it just seems like way too long. So I'm gonna run this now with agency swarm and provide again the same parameters. Awesome, and then we get this complete travel plan as well, and the execution was much faster. So let's print those results with Markdown, because I also really don't like the formatting in Crew AI, so I'm gonna use the formatting from Agency Swarm. So this, as you can see, the results from Crew AI, and this is the results from Agency Swarm. So it's very subjective, but let me try to send it to GPT-40 itself and just ask it which ones are better. I mean, obviously, as I said, it's very subjective, but now let's actually time how long it took Crew AI to complete this. Okay, finally, so I timed the Crew AI execution and it took 10 minutes. It took 10 minutes to complete this cheap plan, and it's not even that detailed. I'm not sure why it's taking so long. I feel like it's calling way too many APIs for no reason, while for Agency Swarm, it only took 3 minutes. And as GPT-40 said itself, the results for Agency Swarm are better. Although, as I said, obviously it's very subjective. So don't listen to me, don't listen to GPT-40. Make sure to play with it yourself and actually try it out. And also, for example, if you look at Matthew Bremen under some videos, you can see that he's actually an investor in Crew AI. So, you know, although Crew AI positions themselves as an open source project, they're actually funded and for-profit company. Yeah, and so there are a lot more features in my framework that I haven't even shown here, like for example async mode. So if you want to learn more advanced features and actually build reliable AI agents, make sure to check out this video next. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe.